Hello, I've been asked to recreate this graphic here, which contains sort of these perspective type building things. Okay, now if you're using Illustrator CS6, it would be very easy because you can just choose the perspective grid here in CS6, and I'm not going to go through that because, you know, it's a completely different thing, but you may not have CS6, so any version before that, you'll probably have to do it the way that I'm going to show you now. Okay, so we'll forget the perspective grid. It doesn't matter which version you've got, you'll be able to do it this way. Okay, so let's start with this building here. This has got these like little double windows in, and I think I counted that there's kind of 8 rows across, and it's actually about 30, it might even be more down, 30, 32, sort of. It's a 32 story building. So what I've done here is I've just drawn these boxes here, and I've used the normal sort of step and repeat idea technique, which I'm sure you know how to do. And now I'm just going to select this slot here. Let me just zoom in so you can see what I'm doing. I'm just going to select these here, and I'm going to make 30. So we're going to do them all in, you know, as if they were just a straight building, you know, looking onto a straight building. Okay, so that's the first one, and now I'm going to press Command D on the Mac. So that's 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18. I'm going to go off the screen, it doesn't matter. 19, 20, 21, 22, 23, 24, 25, 26, 27, 28, 29, 32. All right, so I've done 32 there. Just bring that down so you can see it properly. There we are. So we've got the windows there, and now I'll just put in the sort of the building, if you like. So we'll just do that like that. We want that to be yellow, and we'll send it to the back, which I'm sure you know how to do. So there we are. So we've got the building there. So yeah, well, that's not a very nice yellow. Let's make it a bit nicer than that. Well, that's better. There you are. Okay. So this is this building here. I think it might need to be a little bit thinner, actually. It's supposed to be a skyscraper. So I'll just select it all, and I'll just sort of squash it up a bit that way. Okay, that seems a bit better, doesn't it? Right. Okay. Next thing, we must make sure that we select the whole thing and group it. This is most important, because if we don't group it, we're not going to get the right effect. So we group it, and then we're going to go to Effect, 3D, and Rotate is the one that you need. Rotate. Okay, put Preview on there. The first thing you're going to get is this strange effect, but don't worry, just make this sort of just about kind of like that, really. And it still doesn't look right, I know, but don't worry, we'll make it look right in a moment. Just make sure this is sort of level, and then go to Perspective and just give it some perspective. Now actually that's the wrong way around, so doesn't matter. I'll just move this that way instead of the other way. There we are. And now the perspective will work a bit better. Okay, so we'll give it we can go to town on it actually. There we go. That should work. And if you really want it to, I don't worry about the rotation. You can do the rotation actually here if you want to. You see, you can change the rotation. If you want to, you can do it there. But, you know, we can do that afterwards. It doesn't matter really. We can do it once we've clicked OK and rotate it that way. But, you know, if you want to do it there and kind of just match it up with this sort of by eye. There we go. And click OK. Right. So this is the object done. It's a good idea at this point to expand appearance. There we are. So there's our sort of building in perspective, nicely in perspective, and you can resize it, reshape it, whatever you want, but the important thing is that the windows are you know, in proper perspective, true perspective. Okay, so that's that one. Okay, the others are exactly the same technique can be used in the others, but I'm just going to show you a different way to do it, and that's coming up in just a second. Okay, I'm just going to do this red one and just kind of show you how we can get that effect using a different technique, similar but not using any of the 3D tools. Okay, so this one's a bit easier because it's only three windows, so let's just draw three nicely shaped windows. And again, you just kind of do them as though it's a flat-on type thing. Okay, so there's my three windows. And how many have we got? I think there's about 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. There's about 11. So let's do 11 of these. So here we go. They're about roughly sort of like that, the same gap between each window. There we go. So that's 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. All right. And now we want the actual building itself, so we'll do that. Just make it like that. And this wants to be red and send it to the back. All right. Now this is a nice technique using this wonderful tool here, which no one ever seems to use, the free transform tool. It's very powerful, it's good too. So let's just select it. No need to even group this together actually, this works without it being grouped. I think it does anyway, we'll soon find out. So we want the free transform tool. Very clever tool this, but it just takes a little bit of practice just to use it, because you've got to use three control keys. Okay, so here we go. What you do is start to pull on one corner. Don't let the mouse go, just start to pull and then hold down the command key on the keyboard. Can you see what's happening there? add in the Alt key and see what happens. And now add in the Shift key. And is that wonderful or what? Look at that. Is that great? And if you just do that, you can fiddle around with it till you get what you want. Sometimes I think it's better if you kind of do it upside down. I don't know why, it just seems to look better, but I'll do it upside down, show you what I mean. So I'm going to pull it out that way and let go. Nice. There you are. Okay. Just going to squash it up a bit because I think it's a bit too... there we are. And now it's just a case of if you want to rotate it, you can rotate it and sort of put it the way you want. There you go. That's nice, isn't it? So there you go. There's two different ways, two different techniques that you can use to do those perspective things. So hope that helps. Have fun. Bye bye.